Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to create a custom table or calculate a table in DAX with some custom values. Basically, like you will end up in while you are learning DAX or Power BI, you will learn that you need to create some custom table or the calculated table that contains some list of values, say for example list of currencies, AED, INR, US dollars, something like that. So that once you choose that currency, you are have written your calculations, the DAX measures should behave appropriately. So in order to create those custom tables, you can create anywhere. The simplest way you can create at the SQL, if you are from your data sources SQL, like a database or Oracle, you can create and you can fetch it. But sometimes you are restricted in the database level, you are working only in Power BI. You are supposed to create only in the Power BI layer itself. So in those scenarios, how you can create? There are two ways. One is like you can enter data. I'm not going to talk about it. I'm just show you quickly. But what I'm going to teach you is using a DAX. Since it comes under DAX playlist, using a DAX, how you simply can create a calculated table with custom values. With this note, let's begin. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So I have two examples here how you can quickly create table. So first one, it says like the entire row, the code creates one table, whatever syntax here. So each open bracket and close bracket is your row. So this is one row, and this is the second row, and this is your third row. The entire thing contributes, the open curly brackets, close curly brackets contributes to your table, creates your table. Let's try to understand this one better so that little complex examples, you will understand it easily. Let's try to copy this code and go back to Power BI. Now we have syntax here, like as I said before, you can able to enter the data here, right? You can just create this table quickly, like AED and USD. Okay, this is one way of creating. The thing is like it will create a table at the Power Query layer, and you can see now this will be a table happening at the Power Query. Okay, this is the difference. This is one way, but I'm not talking about it. But some people need to do it in the DAX. Okay, that's the what I'm going to do. So let's do it that way. So go to modeling, create a new table, then just paste this code. Let's see what we are doing. We are saying like currency option. Okay, let's name that table as currency option. Then here, as I said, this is the syntax for creating your table. Each bracket, open bracket and close bracket contributes to one row. So it will create a three rows with this table. Let's try to enter and see it. The currency option table created. You can see the symbol here. It is a calculated table. Let's go and check the data. So here, currency option, as I said, it creates each row, AD, 20 and 80. Now you want to add some more data or row, then just open bracket. Let's say I'm going to add Australian dollars and put 50, then close. So it will create a new row for you. So this is one of the simplest way to create a calculated table with some custom values in DAX. Now let me create this little complex, or it's not a complex if once you understand everything is simple. So you create a new table here. You see, let's say this is the option. Okay, table 2. Okay, so what it does is it creates three rows with four columns. So you can see from the definition, it's the 1.5 is the first column value, and date is your second value, and currency, and A is the some call, you can call it as ID for this rows, A, B, C, something it created. And then you can have any number of rows as it indicates. Let's try to format it better so that you will understand. This is for the first row, the 1.5, 2.5 second row, and you can see the syntax, how it is being written. For mentioning the dates, you need to use date of 2017 1, 1. So this is how you can able to create your table. So the open bracket and close bracket is your table starting and ending, and this open bracket and close bracket is for the single row. You can have n number of columns, and I hope it should have same number of columns for other rows as well. If you remove this one, I hope it will throw error. Let's try to check it out. Now you see each tuple in the table constructor must have a same number of columns as it said. So it should have a same number of columns. It requires a stricter definition, right? Okay, I hope you understand the concept behind how you can quickly create a table using DAX. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.